We need to connect. So how you are going to connect with the Snowflake? So connection can be done with a web-based user interface. That means that you are going to open your browser and go to the URL which has been provided by Snowflake for you. So every account will have an independent URL, individual URL, right? So where the URL will contain an account name, and if possible, it can contain the cloud provider name and the region name also. So everything will be in the what you call the URL itself. Okay, not on all cases. I will tell you about. So that is what you are connecting with the web user interface. Then you have one and only thing which is away from your web user interface is called a SnowSQL. SnowSQL is a command line client. So where you need to run commands using the command line, you can create commands, and SnowSQL is having its own commands also, which we will be seeing sometime later on, right? So how you can access Snowflake and how you can query your data using a client software, right? So this client software can be downloaded from Snowflake itself. Apart from this, there is nothing to be, even SnowSQL also is, it's an optional only, right? So either you can go for a web-based interface, or you can use some other programming language also to access Snowflake data, right? From Python or Spark or any other programming language, you can just connect with Snowflake and you can work on the Snowflake. But if you require a SnowSQL, if you want to connect with command line client, you need to download and do it. Then database drivers are available, ODBC, JDBC, .NET drivers. So everything are available in the Snowflake site itself. So you can go to the URL, help menu, and from there you can download whatever required for you. So if you want to connect with something like SSIS, Power BI or something, Microsoft related tools, so you need a ODBC connectivity. Tableau and some other tools may require a JDBC connectivity, something like that. So if you want to work on on-premises data, that means from your local system, if you want to connect, you need a driver to be installed separately. Otherwise, if you are connecting from cloud to cloud, we don't require any of the connectors to be installed here, right? Then you have native connectors and third-party connectors. So native connectors are connectors created for some of these tools by Snowflake. Third party connectors are connectors created for Snowflake by that particular third party, right? For example, Informatica, Talon, these have their own connectors they have created for Snowflake. Okay, so that is how it works. So you log in into the Snowflake, you have the account name .snowflakecomputing.com. So everyone will have the same type of URL only. So for AWS platform, the region name is included in the account name, except US West Oregon, right? So in the US West, because initially they have started on that only, so that will not be included in your URL. AWS will be suffixed, the suffix of AWS also will be there. So that is what you need to know about the account name, because this is very important actually. So whenever you are connecting from Tableau, whenever you are connecting from any other tool, either it is an ETL tool or a BI tool, they will be asking for what is the account name. So you have to mention the account name. So you should know what is the actual account name will be there, right? So I will show you when we are going on the demo. So just you keep it in mind, some of the regions in AWS, except US West, not some of, all the regions except US West, the region name is included in the URL, in the account name, right? Similarly, Ireland, Frankfurt, Singapore, Sydney, except these regions, .aws also will be suffixed. But for Azure and Google Cloud, all the region names will be there in the URL, and Azure will be added. Azure or .gcp will be suffixed in the URL. For virtual private Snowflake, so you can opt for a virtual private Snowflake, which you cannot get it by in the URL. From the URL, you cannot get it. You cannot register for them. So you need to approach the Snowflake support separately and from your organization level. So it will be done on the organization level. So as an independent, we cannot do it. So you can go for a virtual private Snowflake where you will be having your own kind of private network, right? So connect using the web phase, you need to provide your credentials. So username and password. When you want to connect using your SnowSQL, so there also we have to go for any terminal window. If you are using a Linux or Mac OS or Windows, so whatever terminal window they are having, you can open that and you can provide these commands, SnowSQL. A, mention the account name. U, mention your username login. Then it will ask for a password. You can provide your password and it will get entered. Similarly, SnowSQL contains a configuration file where you can predefine all these information in the configuration file itself. Okay, I'll show you that also how you can do it. Third-party client service and applications can connect using their own methods. So when you are connecting with Python, how the Python library is telling you to connect with. And if you are connecting with .NET, the .NET, how it is using for creating a connection. So in that manner, you are able to connect. Okay. So whatever way you are connecting, you need to specify account name and user. So these are all very essential for getting connected. And optionally, you can specify your warehouse, which warehouse to be used, and which database to be connected directly. Even the schema also you can provide. Right. So these are all optional.